Let's take a look at some basic commands you might use as you create a drawing. We'll begin by looking at layers. Layers allow you to organize the objects in your drawing. You can group similar objects so that you can easily turn them off or on for displaying or printing. And you can lock layers to prevent unwanted changes. Let's open the Layer Properties Manager. This is where you create and manage your layers. I'm going to add a new layer called Objects to this drawing. I double-click to make it the current layer so that the objects I draw are added to it automatically. Let's start drawing. We'll use the Line tool. Typically, when you start a command, you will be prompted to input a value or specify an option. The input expected is displayed as a prompt in the command line window, and also, if you have dynamic input turned on, as a tooltip near the cursor. I'm going to turn dynamic input off for now. To indicate the first point of my line, I click in the drawing area. Now I'm prompted for the next point. I drag the cursor and click again. The line command will continue to prompt me for additional points until I end the command. I can press Escape, Enter, or the space bar, or I can right-click and choose Enter from the menu. To control drawing precision, I can choose from a variety of drawing tools. For example, the Ortho button constrains me to vertical and horizontal lines as I draw. Let's turn Ortho off again. Object snaps allow me to easily place new objects in relation to existing objects. I'll use the Endpoint snap to connect a new line to the endpoints of the existing lines I've drawn. The auto snap markers make it easy to draw with precision.